In order to replace the loading acting on a beam with an equivalent resultant force and specify its location, we can start by converting the distributive loading into known shapes and then calculating the areas of these shapes. These areas basically convert these distributive loading into a point load. So to start, I have a rectangular shape having a width of 9 meters and a height of 2 kilonewton per meter. Multiplying the two will give us a point load of 18 kilonewton that is acting in the middle of the rectangle. Next, I have a right angle triangle with a base of 6 meters and an altitude of 5 minus 2 kilonewtons. This basically gives us the area equals to half times base times altitude equals to 9 kilonewton. Next, the position of this point load will be acting at a centroid of a right angle that is equals to 1/3 of the base measured from the higher end of the right angle triangle. Next, I have another right angle triangle on the right in which we can again calculate the area by half times base times the altitude of the right angle triangle that gives us the value of 3 kilonewton. Now this point load is acting again at the centroid that from a lower end is measured by 2/3 of the base. That's why it is equals to 2 meters. Next, adding them all together give us a final resultant force of negative 30 kilonewton. Here the negative sign is indicating that the force is pointed downwards. Once we have the resultant force, let's identify the position on the beam. So to start, we can draw the resultant force on the beam and specify a distance x with respect to point O as we are solving for this variable x. Now to calculate the value of x, we can utilize our summation of moment of the resultant force with respect to point O that will equals to the sum of moment of all the individual forces with respect to point O. So to start, our 30 kilonewton will make a clockwise moment with a moment arm of x, whereas the 9 kilonewton, 18 kilonewton and 3 kilonewton, all of them will make a clockwise moment as well with the moment arm of 2 meters, 4.5 meters and 8 meters respectively. Simplifying, we get our value of x as 4.1 meters.